Hello everyone, in today's tutorial we're gonna see how to use Photoshop web version to create this double exposure that you can see in here. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, now before we're gonna start, I will show you how to open Photoshop web. Now to do that, you can just go to Creative Cloud in here and head to your apps. And in here you can find these three tabs: desktop, mobile, and web is the one that we wanted. And as you can see, all these apps, you can access them using a web version. For us, we are going to Photoshop, so I will go and click launch. And then your default browser will open and you will wait for it to log in, or it will prompt you for you to log into your Adobe account. But I already logged in my browser, and as you can see, we have in here Photoshop web open, and you can find in here tutorials that will help you to understand this, but it's basically the same. If you know about Photoshop, it will be the same or even easier than the Photoshop app. And of course, it's not the same when it comes to the quality, but it's a very good addition that you have to access Photoshop using the web. Maybe for a client or something, you can make something really quick. If you don't have your laptop with you, you can just use this to create something. For example, I will show you how to create a double exposure like a movie poster using Photoshop web. So for me to start, I can either go to new file, or I can import the image that I want. So I'm just gonna one click on import in here, and then I will select this image that I want from Unsplash, and I will click open. And now I will wait for it to open in the browser. All right, as you can see, this is the image opened in Photoshop web, and this is the interface of Photoshop in the web. It's very easy to do. If you are familiar with Photoshop, even the shortcuts are the same. For example, if I press P, it will go to the brushes, or in here they call it paint, or it's the brushes. And again, if I press G, it will go for gradient. And if I press C, it will go for the cropping, which is actually I'm gonna do. I'm gonna crop this image a little bit, maybe just right here, somewhere around here, and I will click done. And now we have our image in here cropped. And if I press Ctrl Command 0, I can zoom in or fill it in here. Well, you get my idea, it's the same thing. The same thing in here, just using the web instead of the app. All right, next I want actually to make a selection of the subjects for me to create a double exposure. We need a silhouette for this. So I will go to select. And in here we have object selection. You can use the normal like quick selection tool to do that, or you can just one click on this select subject to make it for you, which is what I'm gonna do in here. Very easy. And there we go, we have our selection. And for us to access the refined edge, you can just go to this elliptical or rectangle marquee tool and go to the advanced settings and choose a refined edge in here. Alright, so the refined edge is actually not that good, especially for the hairs. And of course, it won't be the same as the Photoshop app. But for me, I would just one click on this smart radius quick, and I will add a little bit of radius like 25 or something like that. And then I'm gonna smooth the selection a little bit to around 9 or 10. And I will shift edge to minus 6. And then output in here, I will check this decontaminate colors, and I will keep the amount set to 100. But for the output, actually I'm gonna change it to layer mask for us to keep the same layer with the layer mask. And I will press done. And there we go, we have our selection. It's not that bad, but we can do even better using the normal Photoshop app. All right, next I want to make a background or make a solid color in here. Now we can't make a solid color, so instead I will go to the paint in here and I will choose, for example, you can choose gradient or paint bucket to fill the color for whatever foreground color that we have in here. So let's go for a paint bucket and then change the foreground color to a normal grayish color, something like this. And then I will go and one click using the paint bucket. You can just one click on the background and this will fill it. Actually, we need to create a new layer first. So let's create a new layer and call this BG for background. And then I will take this layer down. And now I will one click. And there we go, we have it in black because we see it didn't change the colors. So let's change it to like this grayish. And then I will one click and this will change it to gray. I think it looks nice, but let's actually go back and choose gradient instead and add a little bit of white in here. So for to do that, we can just one click and go down. And I want only a little bit of white down in here, so I will zoom out using the option or the alt key, and then I will one click again and go down actually somewhere just right here to have a little bit of white right in the down part in here. All right, I'm happy with this background as a draft. Now we can just go and open the image that I want to use for the double exposure. So I will take it and drag it very easy and it will open in here. All right, now this one, I will keep it the same, or maybe I will even make it a little bit bigger. Something like that. All right, I think this is enough. And then I'm gonna change the blending mode of it to, and as you can see, we have all the blendings in here. So the go-to for blending a double exposure is lighten or screen. So let me actually go for lighten and see, or screen. Yeah, I think I like screen more, so I will keep it screen and I will click done to commit the changes. And then I'm gonna place this image a little bit up for us to have the person in here sitting just right there. And I think I want to make this a little bit bigger to have this interesting look of two characters. All right, something like that. And again, I will click done. All right, I'm happy with this. Now I want actually to make a copy of this layer mask to this image that we have on top. And to do that is the same thing. You can just press Alt or Option on your keyboard, and while you are pressing it, just go to the layer mask in here that we have and one click and take a copy. While you are still pressing Alt or Option, it will make a copy and put it for this one. All right, next we need to actually brush a little bit from this image, especially in the face, to create that blending in here, to have the face in here visible. And to do that, we're gonna press B for the brushes. And make sure in here that your foreground color is set to black and background color is set to white, for us to, you know, go between black and white to reveal and hide from the layer mask. All right, so I'm gonna right click actually to control the brush size. You can do it by right click on your cursor, or you can just use your bracket keys like this to make it bigger or smaller. And for you to actually change the opacity, you can just open the panel and then in this advanced settings, where here you can find the opacity in here that you can change. All right, so we have the opacity set to 60 and I would keep everything else the same. The hardness set to 0, and then using black as my foreground color, I can just delete from the layer mask to reveal a little bit from the face. Something like that. And to actually show from the layer mask, you can press X to go between black and white, because I really like this part in here. Just gonna delete this part. And also I want to delete a little bit from the edges. So I will zoom out a little bit. And I will delete a little bit from this part in here. Alright, I think it looks nice. A decent draft. Alright, I think I'm happy with this. So I will keep it like that. And then I want to add a little bit of adjustment on top. And also if you want, you can add a text in here. But for me, I will keep it like that. Or maybe I can add it later. So I will switch to my move tool. And I will open actually the panel in here. And the good thing about this Photoshop web, you will find these quick actions that you can use to apply really nice actions or really nice adjustment to your image. For example, whatever had to do with lightning, you can find like options in here that you can just, it's like an action, you can just one click on it and it will apply it. I like this warm filter, but I want something that it has to do with colors, like a duotone or something. So I will go for this duotone blue and I will add it. And the other thing that I don't like is actually it's added on the layer mask shape. So for me, I will just delete this one for now. And I will make sure that I'm selecting the layer itself. And I will one click on the duotone in here. And again, actually it's merge everything. So to avoid that, let me delete this one. Let me actually select all the layers that we have. So I'm gonna select the background and I will press shift and I will select the three of them. And then I'm gonna press Ctrl Command G to create a group. And let's call this original. And as you can see, when I created the group, the quick action disappear. I can't access them, which means I need actually to flatten this group. And for me to do that, I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J to create a copy of this. And then I will right click and choose merge group. And now I have two images in here that I can have the original in here and also the final draft. All right, now I can just apply this duotone that I want and this will apply it to the whole image. Doesn't look bad, but maybe I will put down the opacity of this to like 50%. Yeah, like 46%. And I think it looks really, really nice. It goes with the whole image in a really nice way. And you can choose whatever quick action that you have in here. You can choose auto contrast, for example, to make your image more contrasty. For me, I don't like that. I like it to be a little bit desaturated like this. And maybe you can go to something vintage if you want, or to make a cool filter. Let's see what this does. This is actually too cool for me. Maybe I will go for a warm filter. And bring down the opacity a little bit more to like 20%. And that will be our image. As you can see, it's not something very fancy, but for a draft, you can easily create this double exposure and go back to your Photoshop app and make more changes to the whole image. And I think it's a really great addition to have a Photoshop web in here. And for you to save this, you can just save it. So it's actually been saved on the cloud in here, as you can see. And for you to rename this, you can just one click on this down arrow in here and choose a rename. And for example, you can call it double exposure draft 2 and then click rename. And then we have it with the name in here and make sure that it's saved. Now it's saved. And for you to maybe save this as a PNG or JPEG, you can just go to the three line in here and choose export as, and for example you can choose PNG and wait for it to save the document. Alright, and then you can just choose your folder that you want. And there you go, we have the double exposure draft 2. And click save. And then you can go to your folder and you will find it in here saved as a PNG. And that will be all. Alright, so I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know, wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.